passionate commitment of our mother foundress, servant of God, Tatipatri Nyanamma Innaya. From the outset of the work of evangelization, the missionary, planting and expansion of the church require the presence of the religious in all its forms. History witnesses to the outstanding service rendered by religious families in the propagation of the faith and in the formation of new churches. From the ancient monastic institution to the medieval orders and all the way to the more recent congregations. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, seasonal greetings of love, joy, and peace. I am pretty sure that you are aware of many religious congregations, many of them would have been founded either by saints, priests, or nuns. But to your surprise, I am glad to share with you today about a heroic foundress, servant of God, Tatipatri Nyanamma, who was a lay woman and who founded the Congregation of Society of Sisters of St. Anne, Madras. As we celebrate her 144th death anniversary today, I feel privileged and honored to thank God for all the marvelous the Lord has done for us in and through our foundress. At the outset, I would like to begin my sharing with you the life sketch of our mother foundress. Our foundress Tatipatri Nyanamma was born to devout Catholic parents in Guntur in Andhra Pradesh in 1822. In 1837, young Nyanamma was given in marriage to Innaya, the catechist of Ferengipuram. This pious couple was blessed with 5 sons. Our foundress was a daring woman of her times. At the age of 37, Mother Nyanamma lost her husband. As a widow, she put her entire trust in God and raised her children in strong Christian faith. 4 of her sons joined religious life, 2nd son settled in family life. Freed from all family commitments, Nyanamma moved to her relative's village called Yerayur near Chennai and later shifted to Kirachedi since it is near to your church and she can attend daily Eucharist. It is said, when you kneel in front of God, He stands up for you, and when He stands up for you, no one can stand against you. It was very much true in her life. She used to spend long hours in prayer after the Eucharist, which was the greatest inspiration for her in opening a school and later the religious congregation. Her spirit at work. During her times, education for girls was a distant dream. Those days, women, both young and adult, were meant only for kitchen and other household works. No one could ever think of a girl being educated. They were to remain in ignorant, illiterate, and be confined to the darkness of a kitchen. In Kirachedi, the primary school run by the Franciscan brothers admitted only boys. Nyanamma, who taught catechism for both boys and girls, realized the painful plight of gender disparity. Providing education for girls had always remained a constant drive in her mind. She was convinced that she had been plucked and planted at Kirachedi for a specific purpose. Being uneducated herself, she understood the value of education, especially for women. With the help of Father Arukyanada, parish priest of Kirachedi, she took a daring step to start a school for girls. Her deep intimacy with our Lord, her passionate commitment to do something for the betterment of the girls, always moved her onward. She went to her native Ferengipuram, sold all her properties, and invested the money in constructing a school and a hostel for girls. She undertook a whirlwind tour to raise funds. her dreams come true. Her efforts bore abundant fruits, and on 3rd May 1863, the first girls' school at Kirachiri became a reality. It was the first school for girls in the adjacent villages. Her primary aim of opening the school and the hostel was to provide knowledge about Jesus and to inculcate Christian values along with secular education. Mother Nyanamma involved in religious instruction round the clock. Inspired by the committed work of Nyanamma, Angela and Philomena joined the school as hostelers. Later, in 1871, they decided to become religious sisters. At that time, Father Arokyanatha, who was in Bellary, invited Nyanamma to send the two young women to be formed at St. Anne's Novitiate of the Good Shepherd Congregation in Bellary. On 4th October 1874, both returned as the first sisters of the congregation. Mother Nyanamma's unstinted hard work, chronic asthma, and long tedious journeys made weak and ill, she went to her eternal abode on 21st December 1874. It always intrigues what people say on their deathbeds. Very often, coming face to face with mortality strips away pretension and exposes the true heart of an individual. Her parting message at her deathbed creates profound impact on the life and mission of our sisters. Her parting message was, "My beloved children, be obedient to those who are responsible for you. Listen to your spiritual guides. Besides giving academic and religious education to girls, be the protection and solace of women. Learn to live as women of service and translate love of God into love of fellow human beings. Do not be dependent on the government or others financially. May your hard work be your protection and strength." My dear friends, every day is a gift unfolded by the providence of the Lord, but He crowns few days with notable significance. 21st March 2014 was one such a memorable day when we gathered to hear the good news that our foundress, Mother Nyanamma, was conferred with the title Servant of God. The exemplary life of a foundress gives us a fresh challenge in today's social context. The mission today calls us to have preferential option for the poor in our ministry and discover God in the oppressed. We are sure that the spirit of our mother foundress will continue to kindle the fire of zeal in every sister of our congregation. The journey which Mother Nyanamma took in 1874 with just two young professed sisters had reached the state where we are today. We march on with great vigor, reaching out to the people who are on the margins of the society. We continue to engage in ministries that affirm the original spirit of our founders. Today, we are a group of willing hands, committed minds, and compassionate hearts. And we are confident that the strong vibrations of a foundress will continue to illuminate, guide, protect, preserve, increase, and strengthen us in our journey of religious life and committed mission towards a just and equal society. Our vision is to grow in God experience in solidarity with the oppressed and to contribute towards a just society. Therefore, we decide to live our God experience by identifying ourselves with the oppressed in their life struggles for liberation. Our charism is Fullness in God and service in simplicity. Fullness in God, which means being fully in the awareness of God's presence. It implies the awareness that with all our faculties of mind, body, and spirit, we can attain fullness by living in the presence of God. Service in simplicity. It implies living with a pure heart, living a life of humility, holding on to truth with the guidance of the Spirit to serve God in complete joy. Our foundress's passionate commitment let herself engulfed by the flame of love of God and love for His people. Our congregation reflects her spirituality by making her lifestyle as our way of life. On this auspicious day, I wish and pray that may God's choicest blessings be poured upon each of us as we joyfully prepare ourselves to celebrate the great feast of Nativity of our Lord Jesus Christ. May Servant of God, Tatipatri Nyanamma, intercede for all of us. May you and your families cherish the wonderful memories of love, care, and hope. May you live your life in joy and peace. Thank you.